In this video, we'll see how to use the put middleware in order to update data in ScyllaDB. So let's get started. Right, so we're almost done with this application. All we need to do is somehow show that our task was done. And in this case, I'm gonna create a new column and I'm gonna add a checkbox on the left side of each item. So I'm gonna add a form. And I believe in Bootstrap, in React Bootstrap, it's form check. So I'm gonna new form and form check of type checkbox, of type equal to checkbox. And let's test that. Okay, so it looks like my layout is a little bit off. So I'm gonna add a layout access of one and an access of one to the delete button as well. Okay, so now it's looking good. And what I'm gonna do a little bit like before, I'm going to create a function that we're gonna call toggle completion. So on click, it's gonna be equal to toggle completion. We're going to define this toggle completion function in the item component first. But pretty much like before, what's going to happen is it's going to call another function, and let's call that function on item update. So on item update, and we're going to pass actually a new item. So let's pass all the elements of the item with the exception of completed, that is going to be equal to actually the opposite of completed. And we're going to pass that as a prop, and we're going to define it in the parent component, which is the to-do list. So in to-do list, a little bit, we're going to pass the on item update as a prop. And it's in an error because we haven't defined it yet, but let's define it now. So the const on item update. So what is it that we're going to do now? Just like before, we're going to pass item as a parameter, and we're going to use Axios. So we're going to send a put request. So instead of delete, I'm just going to send put with the ID as a parameter in the URL. And we will handle the front end later on. I'm going to pass item to my body, and let's make sure that it's async. I'm going to go back to my backend. Oops, I can notice that I forgot about an await here. So await and async. So what I'm gonna do is just copy this delete function here and paste it. I can use the same one actually. So update, the same parameters. The only thing is I need to get the item object from the body. And I specifically need just the completed. I don't need anything else. Let's change the query. So update items set completed to my completed, where ID equals to ID. And I'm gonna add completed in my parameters. I'm also gonna change the middleware to put. And let's test this out. In the browser, I don't see anything, but if you go to my API, I can see that it's turned to true. I'm gonna make it a little bit nicer by actually adding a text decoration here. So I'm going to go to my front end app, and I'm going to create an app.css file. So it's just a little bit of CSS. So the first thing that we're gonna do is body margin top actually. A margin top of 50 pixels, and what I'm gonna do is I'm going to have a class named completed, and I'm gonna add a text decoration of line through. Okay, so here in my item component, what I'm gonna do is just make sure that the line through the completed class is added every time I update the parameter, or every time my checkbox is changed. Okay, so let's add a class name here. What I'm gonna do is use a ternary operator, or I can use it like this for now. Items.complete ?? .completed. So if completed is true, then I'm gonna have completed. Otherwise, I'm not gonna have anything. All right, okay, and let me add the app.css to see my changes. And there you go, I can see the margin top here. Another thing that I'm going to do, I'm gonna add a little bit more control to this form. So let's see, when item is completed, then it's checked. Here it's complaining, it's asking me for actually two things. So first of all, I think I made a mistake with the ternary. Yeah, this looks better. But it also is asking me to actually change the onClick method into an onChange method, which I'm going to do. But I also will need to use state here. So this item completed is actually not good enough to show my changes, because it doesn't show any update in reality. And in order to force a re-render, then I have to set a state. So let me change the onClicking. And now let's create a state. Okay, so I'm gonna use the code snippet and I'm gonna call my state completed. Okay, I'm gonna have this completed function and I'm gonna initialize it to item.completed that we have through the props, and I'm gonna add the react.useState here, and I'm gonna change the item completed to completed, and when we toggle completion, I just wanna change my state, so I'm gonna set completed to not completed, so the opposite of completed. And okay, so here the line through is not working, yeah, because I need to remove this and set it to my state, and now it's working. All right, perfect, great. That's all for today. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next episode of ScyllaDB. Thank you.